In this video, I'm gonna to show you what a bad material looks like and how to turn this into a that with just a few steps. Welcome back to Primal VFX. I'm your host, Scott. And if you want to see more cool shit like that, smash the like button, subscribe for more awesomeness, and let's dive in right now. Alright guys, to start this project, we need a good model. So let's take this sci-fi crate. It is a well-made model with some pretty decent topology. I've already made the material subdivision of the model by creating multiple materials like metal, rubber, plastic, and so on. So next up, I've set up a basic look dev scene with the model. Everything is clean and tidy as I like it. If we look a moment to the setup of the scene, it's pretty basic. We've got an HDRI, a top light, a left and right light. And of course, we've got our studio backdrop. It is a pretty basic studio lighting setup. I've also already set up our main camera with a 80mm focal length. If I open the outliner, you can see that everything is clean and tidy. It's important to have everything well organized if you work in production with a team. So it's good to get into this habit early on. Okay, let's get things started. Let's switch to my shading workspace mode to optimize my viewport space. Select these shaders and click on this button to show all of them in the graph node viewport. Now we can organize a bit our workspace. First, we want to set up each shader individually with some basic values for their respective properties. Let's select our first material, plastic black. Now let's launch the IPR to see what we've got. Let's tweak the base color first. Then we can adjust the value of our roughness. Something around 0.45 will do. Increase the specular color to a full white. Let's decrease the base color to a darker tone. Sweet. Change also the IOR to a little lower value. Something like 1.52. In the code section, increase the weight to 1. Lower the roughness to 0.01. In the IOR to 1.1. Pretty nice. Now let's save this shader as a preset. Alright, then select the plastic orange shader. In the attribute editor, click on the preset button and search for plastic black. Now it replaces all selected. Nice. It has replaced all the values with our previously copied material. Now we just need to change the base color to an orange tint. Let's tweak it a bit further. We might also want to change the specular color to a yellowish tint. Pretty nice. Now let's move on to the metal shader. Let's decrease the weight base color to 0.6. Lower the base color to a darker gray. Increase the metalness value to 1. Now change the roughness value to around 0.35. Maybe more around 0.45. Let's tweak a bit again the base color. Now let's add a coat. Increase the coat weight to 1. Change the IOR to 1.55. Cool. Next up, the rubber material. Change the base color to a dark gray. Change the roughness to a pretty high value, as it is a material with very low gloss. We might also tweak the IOR to a lower value than plastic. Increase the specular color to white and decrease the weight to 0.5. Alright. Now that we've completed the setup for our basic shaders, we can move on to the next phase. This involves the addition of surface imperfections. Adding such details in CGI is crucial for achieving professional quality materials. These imperfections introduce realistic elements that mimic the natural wear and variability found in real-world objects, enhancing the overall believability of the render. So let's begin with the plastic black material. So first off, let's pick a texture. This dirt grunge texture is pretty interesting. So let's go with this one. Select it and drag and drop it in the hypershade. Now create an eye triplanar and connect the two nodes like that. Then create an eye range. Connect the out color of the triplanar node to the input of the eye range node and the eye range out color R to the specular roughness input. Let's rename everything properly. Okay, then launch the IPR and select the solo button to see better what we are doing. In the AI triplanar node, let's tweak the scale. Let's lower the value further to increase the size of the map. Alright, then select the AI range node to tweak and remap the values. We want the white and black value around 0.4. Nice. We can now adjust the base color to a slightly brighter value. Now let's add some bump. Create an AE noise and an iBump2D node. Connect the nodes like that. Okay, then launch the IPR and select the solo button to see better what we are doing. Select the AE noise node and increase the scale value. A bit more. Oops, I've made a mistake. Please cancel the link between the AI noise node and the AI bump node and reconnect them correctly like this. Increase the bump height slightly. Actually, it's already too much. Lower it to 0.0005. Yes, much better. A really subtle effect. Now let's do the same for the orange plastic material. Take the roughness and the bump node and connect them exactly as the plastic black material. Sweet. Now let's move on and do the same process for the metal shader. This time let's pick this texture because it has some sweet details. Select it and drag and drop it in the hypershade. Now create an AI triplanar and an AI range. Connect all the two nodes like that. Let's rename everything properly. Select the AI range out color R to the specular roughness input. Okay, then launch the IPR and select the solo button to see better what we are doing. In the I triplanar node, let's tweak the scale. Alright? Then select the AI range node to tweak and remap the values. We want the white and black value around 0.4. Increase the contrast to 2. Nice. Now let's move up to the next step. We want to mix the metal and the plastic shader together. So create an iMix shader. Delete the shader engine and reconnect the nodes like this. Rename the node properly. Now to drive the mix, we need to create a curvature node. So click on Tab and search for iCurvature node. Connect the outColor R to the mix input of the AI Mix node. Okay, then launch the IPR and select the solo button to see better what we are doing. Select the AI Triplanar node and increase the multiply value to 10. Increase the samples to 8. Change the radius to 0.5. Maybe 0.3 is better. Pretty nice. This time let's pick this paint texture because it has some interesting details. Select it and drag and drop it in the hypershade. Now create an AI triplanar and an AI range. Connect all the two nodes like that. Select the AI triplanar and change its scale to 0.01. Lower it again. Nice. Increase the contrast to 3. Better. Now let's tweak the output min and max as usual to remap the texture. Now let's check the result of that mix. Yeah, pretty interesting. Now let's do exactly the same for the orange plastic material. Create another AI mix shader and reconnect the nodes like the previous example. Alright, don't forget to rename the node to keep everything clean and tidy. Sweet. Now our final step. Let's add some dirt. So create another AI mix shader and connect the nodes like that. Then create another material for our dirt. Cancel the shader engine and rename the node to AI Dirt. Then connect the out color of the dirt shader to shader 2 input of the AI Mix shader. Change the base color of the dirt to green for now, so we can see what we are doing more clearly. To drive the mix of the dirt, we'll use the ambient occlusion. So create an AI ambient occlusion node. Connect the node like this. Select the AI Ambient Occlusion node and invert the white to black and black to white color. Increase the samples to 8. Reduce the spread to 0.1. Now let's pick our texture that will drive the spread of the ambient occlusion. This one seems pretty interesting. Create an AI Triplanar node and an AI Range node once again. Connect everything together like that. Select the AI triplanar node and tweak the scale attribute. Select the AI range node and increase the contrast to 5. Nice. Adjust the spread value now of the ambient occlusion. Better. Now let's check our mix shader. Pretty nice. Now we just need to tweak our dirt material. increase the roughness to 0.8. Lower the IR to 1.35 and change the base color to dark gray. For the last step, we just need to replicate everything for the other plastic material. So create an eye mix shader and reconnect everything as before. And boom, the final result. Really, really nice. This is a straightforward way to add a lot of detail with surface imperfections. A simple yet effective method to transform your basic materials into professional quality ones. What do you think, guys? Drop a comment below with your thoughts or any questions you might have. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.